Okay, hello and welcome. This is going to be a brand new campaign for the Emperor Edition. This is the campaign of Imperator Augustus. I have actually recorded a part for this previously, but I think one of my mods was messing with the game. For some reason, some of the text was missing. When I was read, there was none of this, and there was no faction names for peoples. I knew what some of them were, and I couldn't even see if there's bloody... I couldn't even recruit units as well, which is a bit annoying. So I've had to restart it. But from what I've gathered so far, these guys do not like you. Octavian's Rome, Anthony's Rome, and Bombay. I'm going to be playing as Lepidus. Reason being is 100 people are going to probably do Octavian, as it's, you know, he was the actual emperor out of this historically. Mark Anthony's Greece, I pretty much rinsed this area with all my faction Let's Plays. Some of the big YouTubers are doing Pompeii, so I'm not going to bother. This is what I wanted to do, but it's kind of like the Syracuse in the standard campaign anyways. Unfortunately, I have done Lusitani before, but the units you're going to be getting are going to be some Lusitani ones, or basically Iberian ones, and Rome. So it's going to be similar. Lepidus, so Octavian will have Gaul or Gaelic units, and then the Roman ones. Anthony will have Roman slash Hellenistic ones, and Pompey, I assume, will have some African ones and Rome as well. Same for me, actually, because obviously I'm based in that area. Okie dokie. Rome of all the world, it is her destiny and always has been. Claiming a line sent back to Hercules, Romans are not lacking in pride. Romans are not lacking in fierceness. Their city was founded by Romulus and Remus, the twins raised by a wolf. Roman armies may have been beaten, but they will always drag themselves back into the fight and battle on. And now surrounded by rivals and potential enemies, Rome faces challenges at every turn. He who rules in Rome can rule the world, but only through the glory of conquest. Okay, Pax. Roman legions plus one recruitment slot in all your provinces. One ruler. All Roman factions has a major diplomatic penalty with all other Roman factions, cultural aversion. Like I said, these guys are going to be able to declare war on you. They fucking hate you, because... Hence it's the, I can't pronounce it, but it begins with T, Tri, Competitive Wars or whatever, or Trivernum, something like that. Deadly Aim, plus 2 experience ranks for missile recruits, military underdogs, plus 5% non-mercenary recruitment costs, and Agrarian Wisdom, basically agriculture. Okay, let's read, this is cool actually, because I can actually read this out now, because the text is here. The man who said hell... half no fury like a woman scorned, had clearly never met a betrayed Roman politician. Lepidus supported Anthony through the turbulent wake of Caesar's murders, become a member of the second, this is a word I can't pronounce, triumvirate, which divided the public into three parts. When Anthony and Octavian garnered enough prestige and authority, however, they redistributed the territories at Lepidus' expense, consigning him to Africa. There he bides his time, drawing on massive agricultural potential and waiting for the first signs of vulnerability. Rome is just a short voyage across the water, what to say, but it be his. Okay, this first video is not going to be an awful lot of action, it's going to be building stuff and me waffling. So basically, from watching the HBO series of Rome itself, documentaries and other things, I'm not going to be 100% accurate with my stuff, I might be slightly off. But how things worked is, obviously I didn't even know about Lepidus, it's the only one I didn't know about. Pompey, this is the son of Pompey himself. Pompey's, his dad, was friends with Gaius Julius Caesar. Gaius Julius Caesar and Mark Anthony. Mark Anthony was one of his generals. Octavian, I don't think it's historical, but in the program, Rome, he is the nephew of Julius Caesar, who is then, in the will of Julius Caesar, made, gives him all his money and basically carry on the bloodline, because Julius Caesar never actually had a son, so basically adopted him and gave him all the powers, blah blah blah. Anyways, going back to the program, Gaius Julius Caesar is getting a lot of territory in Gaul, which is modern day France. he wasn't supposed to expand there. The Senate didn't like it. Pompey's kind of been told to go to Julius Caesar. Oi, what are you doing, mate? Like, calm down. Julius Caesar's obviously doing this on purpose. He wants to get his troops trained, he wants to get more money, and he wants to get slaves. He sends all this stuff back to Rome, all the plebs or the normal people. Hey, we love you, you're expanding. And he comes back and he has a triumph. He's basically seen by the plebs as God. He then somehow worms his way into power. He gets stabbed by everyone in the Senate, because obviously the Senate not pissed off of him, because they're like the hierarchy at the time. Basically, rich people, posh people of the time, they didn't like it, so they stabbed him. Mark Antony flees, Octavian is biding his time, and obviously all this shit happens, and this is basically the aftermath of the first unofficial Roman Emperor, Gaius Julius Caesar, which is the first war, or whatever, and this is the second one. But in actual history, Mark Antony gets surrounded at Alexandria, because he's in cahoots with Cleopatra, which is in Egypt. Cleopatra coming at you. He commits suicide. Lepidus, I do not know actually what happens to him. And then Pompey's son, I assume, probably just gets murdered as well. But basically, the first official Roman Empire is Octavian Augustus. Enough of that. Let's get on with show on the road. Get this show on the road. But the things obviously are going to be a lot different in this is the battles. The balancing for the units. The battles take a lot longer now, which is, for me, it's going to have to make me learn a bit better because I'm not very good at micromanaging, so I think it's probably a good thing. I have it on hard mode, which probably means very hard for this, but hey, I might as well test it out. If it comes worse, I'll start again on normal mode. But yeah, they're very more long-winded, which is probably better because some of the battles are very quick in the previous patches. Before this edition, so you have to bide your time. You've got to use your micromanage a lot better. There's different building stacks. There's also obviously the pinnacle system and stuff like that, which is obviously way more advanced than which should have been in the original last year, but we shall see. I've played it for about 4 turns, but without the text and stuff like that, I haven't really learnt too much, so it's gonna, you know, bear with me so I get used to it. And I hope you enjoy it, really. It's cool, you know, this is pretty much like a, I wouldn't say completely new game, but 80% a new game, so it's, you know, gives a bit more life into it.
You are my son, but I've done all I can to protect you.
The gods smile on you, Octavian. You're a good soldier.
I'm a politician.
We don't need more politicians. It's not more speeches in the Senate that will change the world. Rome is dying.
Why do you think Caesar favored you so?
I was loyal.
No, Octavian. He saw in you the potential to continue his legacy. Not to follow him, but to exceed him.
Antony cannot be trusted. His heart lies in Egypt. We must confront the reality that civil war is inevitable.
And how will bloodshed save the people of Rome?
You are not meant to save them. You are meant to lead them.
All men are troubled when their moment has come.
I am not Caesar. I don't have his strength.
The people loved him, and they will love you.
You can't think like an ordinary man. You must reach beyond mortal ambition and do what has never been done.
Survive, my son. Rome must have a master.
Oh yeah! It's gonna be Lepidus, motherfuckers. Espanol is going to go for the win. And Africa. Okay, you are Lepidus. Yes, we know that. Hemmed in the edge of the world by your nominal allies, Octavian and Mark Anthony, you know that this uneasy peace cannot last. Still, it'd be wise to avoid direct conflict with them for now. Focus on consolidating your position in Iberia by subduing the Canterbury and enlarging your African domain. Conquest of Pompey's Mediterranean strongholds is a demanding task, but will give you a foothold in Octavian's territory. That may prove extremely valuable when the triumvirate collapses. When this happens, it is an inevitable must. I've probably said that wrong. The betrayals you suffered in the past will make victory all the sweeter. Okie dokie. Whoa. Not over there, thank you. Complete control 8 provinces, either by direct ownership or through client states. Yes! I can see the fucking text. I think. Yay, Anthony's Rome. Sweet, sweet, sweet. Okay, last time, managed to get a lot of trade with people, and I noticed...
I am here to listen, if you speak on...
Oh, maybe not.
My people.
Welcome, friend.
The African nations like me, because obviously I'm surrounding them, I'm quite superpower. And one thing I noticed as well, that on the research... Iberia, oh, okay, that's who that was.
Now speak plainly, for we...
Okay, let's sort these things out. They're actually a client state of me.
I will be a patient audience for you. You present?
I'll show you the reason why these guys are probably highly wanting to trade for me. Because there's two new things with this. Okay. Research. Yes, currently this is already open for me. Because I was clicking on it, I was like, why is it not bloody working? It's obviously been clicked, you see, it's already got a tick on it. And these have been unlocked. You've already got a few for me. The only one that hasn't been done is obviously this, so let's go with the military route. Yeah, so that's already done for Lepidus. Got Pompey there. Got Pompey. Pardon me. Let's actually check the troops, because this wasn't coming up before for me. Yes, it's working. I couldn't bloody recruit troops either. And I think it's because of the Troy Reborn mod. It wasn't working. So the things I notice is obviously very, very bad public order. And this should be due to corruption. Okay. Desert nomadic and probably cultural stuff as well, which is not helping it. So this is a little bit different. What needs... 8. This is not full province. That is -3. So we've got 2 edicts we can do, so food, public order, that'll help with that one. That's not full province, this one is, so again, we need to build, money wise first, we need purple building, public order, culture, supposedly as well, which are, cool, that's cool. I can actually see the recruitment things now. So we get better garrison units for this, which is, I heard that they change, as you can see here. And you also get Latin cultural influence for an upgrade. I either can use that or just growth. So for this, I would do that. And it's going to cost you 1 food. So they've changed some of the stacks for this as well. I won't do that yet. Because I need to sort out other things first. Here we've got grain, so this is what I was going to mention a minute ago. So resources for the area, so as you can see here, I've got grain, which is like the African thing. I can upgrade that, provides garrison, okay. There's no negatives for that, so this can help me with food and stuff like that. There's also... This is why people will probably want to trade with me. I have wine as well, which is at Gades. So, usually before, like for instance these guys, I should really take on a Takabura, because obviously they've got Shumat's iron, whatever. You get these buildings now. This is why people will probably want to trade with me, because I think I've got 2 resources at least for free, including that grain. And if you upgrade that, public order goes up, wealth, etc. There should be another one floating around. There we go, we've got olive oil as well. Olive oil. Olive oil, we're going on about. But I need the money for that, so what we got? Purple building we have got here. Is there one missing? Purple building, here we go, we need to do purple here. Last time, because like I said, I've recorded this unfortunately before, but it's probably going to help me a little bit. Octavian and these twats declare war me, Pompey. So let's move him up to there, because they're going to be attacking from the north. He's obviously got all this land, so we do need to try and be quite friendly with him. It's hard mode, so it's going to be difficult. These guys can move to Abusum. These guys stay here. These are my client states. All this area, so they can help me. This guy's not, so we can attack him at some point and them to secure. Yes, we definitely will, because we want to secure all of that. So they stay there. These guys actually need to stay there because the public world is pretty shit. And they're moving up. We've got a spire. These things I'll have to try and figure out at some point where political order and all that kind of shit works and different buildings, but I'll quickly show you what I do know. Obviously this secure promotion is first. Obviously things are going to be more gravitas per turn, so you can get traits for your generals which will help you with your Imperium and then obviously with political stance. So secure these first and then I'll explain the other things that I've picked up so far. Some of it was in the original game anyways. But for instance, let's click on him. Ambition. So ambition represents a character's desire for personal power. High ambition increases the effect that character's gravitas has on the party's influence. So obviously they help you gravitas, blah, blah, blah. I think that was in it before. These are the things they currently have. You can click on there's a trait, authority, cunning, and zeal, three of each. And then you've got his son here. These will probably expand later on. You got the politics, which I don't fully understand yet. Same kind of thing, but they're adding the numbers up there. And obviously these ones are not in favour. Oh, okay, cool. So the more you get, obviously the better perks you get. So that respected, and then obviously lower and lower and lower. So this is going to be really bad. And higher, you get better stuff. 20% research rate, public order. So you obviously want to get higher. And it's a civil war meter. Likelihood of civil war breaking out. The higher the influence of the ruling political party, the higher chance civil war becomes. Characters we've just done. Summary is the same as before, really. These are different ones. Public order penalties due to local presence of foreign cultures. So obviously I want to get rid of that. That you would anyways. Yeah, I think that's the same. Diplomacy different? Let's have a look.
Greetings! Speak plainly and without idle.
Probably a few tweaks. But yeah, it's mainly battles, so we have to see it in a minute. So this end of term. I'm actually going to enter war on side of the ally because I don't want to be pissing off Octavian, really. I want to attack Pompey. Yes, that's the right one to click on. They're obviously closer to me, but if Octavian's taking him on as well, he's a bigger threat. So I've got my forces in this kind of area anyway, so it should help me in favour with Octavian. So, Anthony's Rome, Octavia's Rome. Edicts have been issued. So, let's check. They obviously hate me.
Greetings, my friend. You have...
Okay, we've got trade with them now.
Excellent. We accept. And I give thanks to Athena for granting us all wisdom.
So, that's helped me 35. So, that's gone down a little bit. So if we attack Pompey, it's going to help with us, and obviously they hate us anyways, and Decaying War's not going to help. That makes perfect sense, but if we protect my borders... Let's start building some troops in a little, while. The closest threat for me is obviously deer, so we need to build some troops in a minute. 4 grand. -7. Let's get... Oh, we've just run out of money for that. Next time we can do that. To help with cultural differences. -8. Okay. Get some puppet order going. We need to. These guys up here. Let's try and sort this... these areas out. Next time we're going to have to build some troops here. And what can we build? He's got the money to. We can get a spear unit. Got all these spears, aren't they? Yeah. Not the best, obviously. You've got legionnaires, which are pretty good. So let's build one unit for that. Cheapish, though. We'll probably get Mark Anthony attacking us as soon as to get him what I mean soon.
My people are proud.
That's cool. Are you. More friends, the better. This one, and then whatever's left, we'll buy a couple troops here. This is the main one. We need to build it in at the moment. 5, and then rest on spears. Let's go to military route. Let's go up to there. So these are, I checked before, there's nothing really to go over. These have not changed that much, but minus this, maybe a few building chains, like grain silos and stuff like that. But it's pretty much the same kind of thing. All it does is unlock it for you. But say for instance, the 3% tariff income, that's all the same. Agriculture, it's just the actual building chains are different. So let's try and sort these things out. Do some food in a minute as well, I'd say. Okay, that's got that to positive, which is cool. But it seems you've got to be very vigilant with public order and that now. Which is good. Like, you did do before, but this is seems a bit more advanced. Which I do like. So we will sort these out within the next few turns, get some buildings going. But they were the two main culprits, as them two. We can get these building. Get some more money in. So I'll do a couple buildings to sort out public order and then some troops each turn, I'd say. No need to expand at the moment because you got to think I've already
this
got quite
no
a few settlements.
Timidity. In Rome's name, I insist that your armies march against these creatures.
Because they're too far to the east, I might as well declare war on them because it doesn't really matter for me. I hardly doubt I'm going to even attack him in the whole campaign, so anything to make him happy with me at the moment. I've obviously still got a threat of Pompeii right next to me with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 settlements, but obviously they're going to be getting attacked by those other people anyways, so I'd rather that than fucking Octavian after me. Oh, they've actually started to move their troops towards me. So let's get him over here.
Ready for orders.
Because I forget, I do have settlements down here which they can attack. Build that. What are these? Oh, that's the thing I noticed as well. These don't actually do units, but obviously they do specific, like, cavalry melee and stuff like that. Let's get that going. Otherwise we're gonna be struggling for stuff like that. Oh, that shit, that needs to be done as well next turn. While defending this area, hopefully these guys can get here within a few turns. If we do lose like one of these settlements, I'll just have to grab it again. So it's a bit of a harder start because obviously where I've got quite a few settlements, so I need to sort out the bloody infrastructure for it while, okay, they moved back off again, while building a few troops as well. But I don't really need to expand. It's basically
between our peoples would see us all stronger.
I basically need to secure what land I have got now and then expand later on, so it's not as bad. Okay, let's sort these areas out. Top it over. Yeah, okay. I'll leave it at that for these guys, because we want to expand the other units up here. Can they build anything? Whack an extra one in there. Okay, see if there's anything different than these. Not at the moment, but they may even have spires, and that might have gravitas as well, which I think would be good. Traits, tax for local area. So yeah, I think just rinse and repeat really. Obviously I need to sort out my settlements first because public order is pretty shabby. Might have to do another purple building as well. No need. I was going to leave that fleet there to help some public order, but they're going to be needed near Pompeii. So Pompeii's area.
A treaty would be an arrow shot with deadly intent against our mutual enemies.
I don't have the money. Oh no, they're giving me money, weren't they? it's still minus. Does that help with it? Yeah, so we may have to do that, because it's the culture for this one is affecting it. Let's do yellow building. Get some puppet order in that one. So unfortunately we're still trying to sort bloody things out, aren't we? There's this Octavian spy up there. Let's get a couple more troops in case any of it does kick off. And get them docked. Might dock on my rear actually.
Ready for battle.
Yeah, I think the main thing at the moment is the cultural difference. We're trying to sort it out. But they will be going up once these buildings have been constructed in most provinces. And corruption. Can we sort out corruption actually? Might do this one instead. Oh, let's go that route. Tax rate. Yes, we may have to go this route, I'd say. And that help us out. Yeah, let's do this instead of the military side of things at the moment. Because at the moment we're okay military-wise. It's trying to sort out that stuff.
My lord offers you peace. Tom?
It's probably going to piss off Octavian, but we don't care.
I propose a simple treaty.
Okay, I think these are a little bit different. Nah. Cultural conversion, passive, okay. Assassination for that one. You finish off with a couple of elite units of this. Three, I must do Cav. First cohort, Do the Cav first and then we can probably get... Oh, we'll do it in the next full army stack. We've got the first cohort. This will be alright as a basic. We've got the cavalry now to go with it, which is good. Let's have a look. Anything to help with this? Just more money, innit? Let's do a yellow building for this one, I'd say. Get some public order. Maybe another purple for here. Culture will be different. What have we got here? It's another perps, I think. Help with that area. Because it's suffering at the moment.
Ready for battle.
Okay, that's it. Just stick the general in this province at the moment, so we can, no troops, don't have to have any troops with him, but we have the general ready, that'll sort that out. This is a different one, Gades. Next turn we'll have to do the same for the, get a general. Okay, it's end of turn. Recruit a spy. Let's do that. Help some cultural stuff in this area, and then obviously, like I said, let's get a general. Minus one, it's better than nothing. And we can start sorting these things out, get some public order in the area. Wave three.
We hunger for battle. Your orders?
Probably best not to buy any troops at the moment. Expand, no, not yet. We'll do a yellow building in that for the next turn. Yes, I think it's just mainly infrastructure at the moment. And we should start sorting some people out. This research will help us as well, get some tax rates down, and then the next one be corruption, which is not helping. So the thing at the moment is cultural, and we need to convert things culturally. Subject gains notoriety. The name of one of your subjects is the lips of everyone. Whether this proved beneficial remains to be seen. Dingus. That's in positive at the moment. That's in positive, and let's do that. We have to do some food in a minute. One of these for the next term. They're in positive as well at the moment. Shit, what was I gonna say? Oh yeah, this one will have to be level. I'll get them to go level 2. So we're getting there, getting there. It's just trying to sort things out really, because they got taxes as well. But the main thing I think is fucking things up is the culture. But it's slowly going up, so... But we will need to do some food in a minute. Yeah, I think what they've done is set the cost of food going way up for certain buildings. They've done it for all buildings. Well, pretty much most buildings when you upgrade them, but it's like one food at a time. So it's easy to manage. Compared to like 4 or 5 per bloody thing or... So that was a tax rate one, I think. Rubula Alba. One of our family members has been apprehended outside the Senate. She attacked a senator who had spoken ill of her husband, stabbing him through the tongue with a hairpin. You'd obviously punish her, wouldn't you? No, there's no point in doing it because we're not the weaker party yet.
At your command. Ready for battle.
No point building troops in there.
Commander. Commander.
Or in there. Public order is going up now, which is good.
Yes.
One more turn, and then I'll end the first part there. Like I said, though, I knew this would probably be what it is, but I've got quite a bit of land already and money, so for me it's more... It looks like they're going to try and land there. Pompeii. I need to consolidate what I have got really, to be honest. Ooh. After publicly chastising, she apologised, but that was not the end of it. Position women rallied to the women's cause and openly mocked your family for what they saw as an act of cowardice. Fuck off. How's that cowardice? Hey, plus there. Praetorians. Okay, this... public order. Agriculture. Grain pits, this is a new one. Get money for my culture and obviously army replenishment as well, which is good. 5 food, but we want squalor and 7 for that. So let's try the grain pits. That's a bit close. Got 14 units in that, so... And I got this one. We attack. Fleet reporting. Let's try this out as a battle to finish things off. Let's see see what the naval battle's like, at least. They do have two catapult ones. It's a bit annoying. Maybe I should have quick saved. Let's get these in twos. I can focus on the ship at a time.
Support ships ready and waiting.
Ready and awaiting orders. Artillery awaiting orders. Destroy the enemy ships.
Support shells in your command.
Come to battle again, and on a ground of my choosing. At a time of my choosing. I wouldn't have brought you here without absolute confidence in you.
Our reinforcements arrive.
Two arms.
Okay. Ah, it must be from the settlement. Let's see what the artillery's doing. Normally it tells you if he's getting damaged or not. Obviously it tells you how many units are getting hit, but... That one hit. I got a few kills. That's their artillery right there. Oh shit, that one's got barged. Fuck.
Your orders? Understood. Artillery and...
I think that said general, isn't it?
Assault ships reporting. At your command, support ships.
So let's get all these.
Artillery awaiting orders.
Firing at their general. Get their general killed. I think that's the only thing that's going to win it at the moment, because I've lost quite a few units already. This one must be fucked already, come on, let's go to general. Yeah, general's dead now. Oh fuck, my general's dead as well.
We await your command. Fire on enemy ships.
Okay, they've got a huge chunk, let's go.
Firepower ready.
God, let's get these bastards. Even if we lose, just take out what we can. Rebuild the rest.
Target enemy ships.
Oh, they've run out. Let's try and hit. Skirmishes versus skirmishes. Okay, one of my artillery's gone.
Orders! Destroy the enemy's ships!
There we go, we lost. Like I said, I can rebuild them so I'm not too fast. 4 minutes, so I'm still quite quick. And I do have my... They are moving up an army stack near to Carthage, but... I could take that army stack out and then obviously move my guys down to the port if these guys attack, but... I'll quickly rebuild a new fleet and send them their merry way down to here. They would have lost their general and two of their units. It's just the artillery is still left over, unfortunately. But I'd assume they probably wouldn't have... I don't know. They probably could assault the settlement, couldn't they? See what they do. Their general that fucked me over, because I thought, well, I'll leave my general out of it because I'm going to lose him, but he just steamed roll his general with this basically the assault thing and rammed the shit out of my skirmishers. But okay, at least I can use that tactic for the next time against the enemy myself. Okay. Okay, still got them couple of units. I'll send them back to the port.
Ready for orders. Making for port.
Oh, I can actually build them anyways.
Your orders?
Yeah, I can build them again, so it's not a problem. We got the money, so I'll send them back there and then rebuild them. Okie doke. I hope you enjoyed the first part. Obviously, it's a lot more waffling than anything. Next part I'll try and finish off the infrastructure side of it. We're getting into the positives now instead of the negatives of public order. And then we can start focusing on building better armies so we can research discs to get some Legionnaire vets and Praetorians. Better stuff in general and then just try and sort things out. But expansion is not key thing at the moment. It's to basically secure what I have got and then attack Pompeii. And these two factions as well, so we can get this part of Africa under my belt. So I build some troops here as well at Tingis. An army stack over here to secure this area, and then attack these guys as well, so we've got all of Spain ourselves and to secure that area. These are our client states, so at the moment we don't need to attack these guys. May not even never have to attack them. And then we can expand eastwards again, attack them, and then see what Octavian does with us. But I'll see you guys all in the next part, and I hope you enjoy the campaign. See you next time.